Hello everybody, I'm Ignacio Levy, a cameraman and video engineer, and many more. In this short video, I'll show you how the GoStream Deck Kit looks inside, how to open it, disassemble it, reassemble it, and close it. I'm making this video at the request of OSEE Technology, so that you end users, fellow video engineers, bloggers, cameramen, and whoever else would know how hard it is or how easy it is to install your own existing GoStream deck into a kit if that kit is supplied without the deck inside. The deck kit consists of a pretty standard plastic suitcase. The top part houses the display, which we won't look at in this video, it doesn't interest us. Also here you can see that metal angle that is meant to prop up the lid upright so that it won't accidentally close on you. The bottom part contains everything, the deck and all the electronics and all the cables. So here everything is covered by thick steel, maybe 1 millimeter or so, and fixed with 10 screws, 8 along the perimeter and 2 holding tabs that hold the deck in place. The screws are T8 hex, like this. So the screwdriver is the star, but well, an Allen key of that size will do. So let's unscrew these screws. First, we start with tabs. And then continue along the perimeter. The order doesn't matter much. Oops, careful. So all 8 screws are done, and now we can gently pull the metal part slightly up. Gently, because inside there's plenty of ribbon cables, and ribbon cables are known to be pesky beings. So we propped everything up, and now we have to push the SD card adapter so that we can pull everything even further and have a bit more leeway. So now, using a screwdriver or something other thin, we just push the corner of this SD card adapter and gently prying the SD card ribbon cable outside. Like so. It's a pretty standard thing, that adapter. So now we have our deck free from its main holder, and we can gently lift it and pull it out. So we have some ribbon cables and regular cables here, and we can start disconnecting them like you would normally do. Very nice connector, a flat Ethernet cable, a double USB-C adapter on a PCB, and with these HDMIs, we just tugging them gently, holding from top and bottom in a pinch. And laying them down in order so that we won't screw anything up. And here it is, the last ribbon cable. And pretty standard mini jacks. Mini jacks are, by the way, marked, which is a good thing. So now we have our absolutely standard normal GoStream deck without the kit. You can use it separately, you can install other deck inside the kit. So inside, I won't remove everything here because it's affixed with some kind of putty or glue. So here we have another standard power adapter, 12 volt 5 amperes, the whopping 60 watts. Although all the kit, the deck, the display, the fan, everything consumes only 13 watt hours. So a 40 ampere power bank will last you at least 10 hours. And so here is just circuitry, the PCB, and these are the ports that are on the back, and some power circuitry to negotiate electricity. So you have the IEC input here, like your standard computer wire. Here there is a standard DC connector with a screw on, and here you can see the lead that helps you power your deck from a USB-C power bank, or maybe that can be a V-mount battery or just anything USB type C, as long as it provides 12 volts, maybe even less. And so here is the audio thing and audio outputs for mic 1 and headphones, and those are power switches for a fan and the main power switch. So let's return everything to the original state. So we erase this plate and place the deck into its recess. So here it is. Actually, we can start it like here, like so. So here it's mic 2. Let's plug it into mic 2. There goes headphone out. Doing it like so. There goes the mic 1. Like so. And then we're just plugging in all the HDMIs again. Degree of accuracy and some gentle gestures are expected. So we are done with our HDMIs. Now USB connectors and RG45, and finally a power supply. The order you are doing it in is absolutely of no consequence, doesn't matter. So it's just important that everything would be plugged back into its place. So now we put the deck in. And now the most tricky part, we're holding it down, but not too much. So pulling it a bit back and gently pushing the SD card adapter back inside. So now we have everything in place. And we can return the screws back to where they belong. Actually, here is one, a good starting point. Anyway, the screwdriver is a bit away, so let me grab it and return all the screws into their respective places. It's absolutely not necessary to do it with the speed I'm doing it with, because I have some experience with screwdrivers. So do it in your own pace. So the 8th perimeter screw goes in, and now all what's left are two tabs and their screws holding them in place so that our deck wouldn't dangle inside and damage the display. The left tab and the right tab. So, as you could see, everything is pretty sensible, rather neat, and technically, given some skills, it's nothing complicated in making a thing like that on your own, but I don't think it comes any cheaper than OSEE offers it. So, the fan runs, the display runs. And now we're pushing the power on. And so we have our deck kit, pretty functional. Oh, the most important thing. The SD card. So we are done. Thanks for watching.